Do you think like this is part of the a plan by the US government to actually control crypto through the CBDC?
Well, this is the thing, isn't it? we know that US is a powerhouse. They are a superpower, and they have had in recent times a lot of threats to their sovereignty, from places such as China, places such as Russia, and even those upcoming economies like Brazil and India. And now they've got crypto coming in, which is in its own self this entity that kind of takes off by itself and is potentially threatening, one of the biggest exchanges or, exchange of value, which is the US dollar, which is used all over the world. So the US being the military power that it is, it's going to, of course, come in with the forces that it needs to protect the US dollar, to protect the foundation that has already built. However, it might be detrimental to the US if they don't have the full power that they need to kind of overcome crypto, which I don't really believe that they do, because crypto is a global exchange, can be used globally. And the problem with what some people are saying is, obviously you do have CBDCs, and some people in their government are looking to actually want to innovate with them and want to build. However, regulations as well, trying to not over promote crypto and trying to actually protect their fiat currency, means that it's deterring people from actually coming in and innovating. So there's people in the space, they're actually trying to move to safe havens for crypto, like I think BitBoy is one of the biggest crypto influencers, trying to do some deals or move to Estonia. Obviously there's